Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. We are in the morning edition once again because of a fault on my end. it's gonna be today. It actually is today because it's past midnight again. It's Christmas Eve. Well, that's when we celebrate Christmas, basically. So I wanted to make these Rainbow Dash cupcakes for Christmas. They turned out awesome, but I realized that I will not be able to record for Christmas Eve because I'm gonna be having people over. And I was like, crap! So then I went upstairs to record this video. Here I am. So now we're in this odd lava elevator thing of sorts, and you'll notice that my lives reset again. It's because I turned off the game. Doesn't really matter. I'm not going to lose that many lives. Wait, come think of it. 7 lives? You really start with 7 lives? That seems odd to me. Ow. I know I didn't have 7 lives when I ended off the last part, that's for sure. I had like over 20 or something like that. By the way, I would like to show off this. It's a crash power, just as long as it's here. It basically kills all enemies on the screen. It is a broken power that's only used once, so it's not really all that broken. It's used to get this thing right here, basically. Unless you want to try and thread the needle between these critters here. And why can't I get that? Why was it so hard to get that star? I have no idea. It's not like it was hard to get, and why did I try that? It's like that wasn't gonna work at all. Maybe because it's the wee hours in the morning edition of this walkthrough again, perhaps? Anyway, let's just continue on. Coming to kill me. That was like a between a toe and O. I mean, a two and O. Excuse me. Anyway, I think what I'm looking for is a hidden passageway behind the lava waterfall, if I'm not mistaken. You can use these little alcoves to duck and save yourself from getting squished by these blocks, if that wasn't obvious to you. I really don't think I needed to do that, really. So that was kind of a waste of time overall, but oh well, I just thought it would be okay to show. And yeah, you gotta break that, otherwise you won't be able to get through, and strangely hard to break that block with the ninja power. This is what I'm looking for. Don't touch the walls. Don't touch the sides. This is operation. Yeah, it's hot. What you want to do with this is grab onto the wall like about here and shuriken through that. Like that. Whoop. That's how it's done. It's a pretty neat little puzzle they have there, I have to say. Careful. There we go. And the ninja guy, if you need one, is right there. Once you get down here, you can't go back, obviously, because these, you know, all move in succession or blocking your pathway. And once again, you're not touching the sides, so... Oh, high jump power. Woo! Oh my, oh my, oh dear, oh goodness. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. I guess it would be like great balls of Kirby in this, you know... You, never mind. Woo! Oh, pff, that was terrible. Complete and utter terribleness. Oh, I'm gonna have to do one of these Oh my goodness. I don't think that was worth doing. Oh, it was. It was worth doing completely, and I would have missed that if I didn't take that path. So, good for me. This is gonna start closing in, isn't it? Yep! Oh boy, oh boy! Yeah, I knew as soon as I lost the power, I lost the chance of getting out of there alive. Sadly. That was horrible timing on my part. Alright. This time, for real. And I just noticed, I didn't lose that energy sphere that I got a little bit earlier, you know, on this hidden path there? So I guess I can take the safer route. If you collect the energy sphere, you'll notice that there's those stars covered with, like, well, it is like a star in an energy sphere, but it's not an actual gear in an energy sphere. That gives you, well, stars. I forgot how many that thing gives you, though. I'm just gonna fly through that. I'm not gonna even bother using the power there, because that's what screwed me last time. Ooh, now we're underground, and I see some spark. Gotta love the spark. It even illuminates the area. The power of spark cannot be defeated. And I just noticed that there's a star floating around that candle. I never noticed that before. Anyway, I don't want to get the candle wet, obviously. I just want to, yeah, float on the surface like that, and then press left and right to move. And I can't use my spark power, sadly, here, so I can't form a shield, but I don't, oh my. I was gonna say, I don't think that'll be an issue unless I see an enemy that'll go for you. As you know, those little barracuda enemies have the potential of doing so. What's... anything else? This is a jackpot of stuff. And, okay, once I go through the door, I will lose the candle. Yeah. Oh my, oh dear, oh goodness. Must charge shield my shaking controller while running. That actually does come in handy in some places, by shaking the controller like this and moving. Because normally, if you were, you know, using the control pad to rush ahead, it just wouldn't work, you know, to try and make a shield while you're moving like this. Well, what I'm doing right here is I can just... oh my, this is getting a little tight now. But right here... Oh! Okay, yeah, that was a good example of using the shaky shake power of your spark rather than using a D-pad. And I'm just gonna use my spark because, you know, I have spark. And why not? Oh, super bonkers. That likely means we are going to be going over to a interdimension place. I believe that is what I heard the name was it called the interdimension, the place that's goes to that black and white type area thingy dealio. And Super Bonkers really is pretty super. He's got a lot of health, and he also seems a little more aggressive than your typical Bonkers, and I would really appreciate if I could get... yeah, there we go. I suppose that's why he is Super Bonkers. Move over there while I shoot you and kill you. Delightful. I'm glad we can agree on that. And now we will destroy everything! That's fun. Always fun. Oh, and we got these block kind of puzzles here. Depending on how hard you hit them, depends on how far down they move. This is what I was talking about earlier, or at least I think I talked about earlier in the walkthrough. Let's just go up here. Oh, just nothing. Okay, just wanted to make sure. The more you shake the controller, the more powerful it gets, and it'll push those kinds of blocks down one extra square, depending on how many times you charge up. And you want those, like, metal... I want to say fuses, but it's really hard to call them fuses when they look very metallic. I hit that too hard, didn't I? Yeah. It's this for one square, and you want to align it, so now shake it once to get it to the purplish hammer, and that should align it. I guess it is electric. Such technology in Kirby's world, why don't we adapt to this stuff? And that path probably takes you back to the other way if you didn't have your hammer, and I'll just crash this sucker. Break it apart into a million pieces and create a nice platform. Delightful! And I got another one of these puzzles. Shake. No, I don't. Not, no shaking once there, because that'll knock it down two spaces. Just press the button and hit it. Press the button here, hit it. And this needs to go one, three spaces. One, two, three! And that's how it's done. You'll notice that there was a misalignment there as well. It's just something they did to trick you, basically, but no matter how the blocks look, you just have to look at the fuse of sorts. Oh, I love this little contraption they have here. It is a giant burner of sorts. I don't know, it's It looks like it was made in ancient times, but this is clearly modern technology we have here. And once you destroy all these four burner thingies on all the sides, and this big one in the center will open up, you know, in that crystal. How did I miss that? I want to try breaking apart that crystal before I break apart any of the other ones, just for the fun of it. I don't think you can break this with the... Yeah. Despite the Grand Hammer being able to break most things, it can't break glass. I don't get it either. Well, I guess maybe crystal isn't quite a type of glass. Well, it is used for, like, glassware. Well, maybe, isn't it? Yeah, crystal is a type of... What am I thinking? I don't know. I guess because it's, late in the... I mean, yeah, I don't know what I'm saying here. It is wee hours of the morning edition. That's what I'm thinking of here. Ah! I'm really pushing through here, obviously. Oh, this is the one I was thinking of earlier that has little traps as you get further down to try and squish you. So be on the lookout for that. But I'm going to get that one up because it's really, really easy to get. I'm going to have to shift my way through this stuff. No problem. And I guess I'll... Oh, I see. The current is in my way. I didn't notice that before I jumped in the water. And what is this? Oh, it just moves the whole thing. Whenever you hit a switch, be on the lookout for something that's going to squish you. So, yeah. Careful. This is the squishy place. Okay, I don't really have any worries at this point just yet. But I do recall that this is a pretty long structure, so... Be ready. Oh, I should have actually shot through the water to break those blocks as I was moving down. Oh, well. It's not really that big of a deal. That's what I was looking for. And hit that. That was scary. I didn't know what the heck was going to happen there. I believe I have to go up here. Yeah, I didn't stand a chance of getting back over there. Oh, my God. Move faster. Go, 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 go. I'm pushing it. Alright. I'm gonna take... What? They gave... Fine, I'll take it. That's what I need right now. Because of wee hours in the morning edition. You know what? One more time. Oh, okay, that's good enough. I'm feeling wired right now. Actually, that's not true in the slightest. Leaf power? Wow, that's cool. Spear Doomer, what do we have? It is the bomb version, and I'm going to rape you with this. And that floor is not going to make much of a difference at all, especially given the power that I have, which is like aerial dynamic is what I'm saying here, or trying to say here. And, oh, I was a little too late there. I was trying to rush him, like kill him before he does it, did his explosion thing, but alas, I was not fast enough. Kind of being reckless here because I know that, you know, you get a reckless tomato after everyone. Did I say a reckless tomato? A maximum tomato after each one of these fights. So, yeah. There we go. Now, we go down and there it is. Whoa! And is it me or was this a very long level? Look out for the nuclear marinara sauce as you're running to the store. There can't be much more, can there? I just rhymed. I was a poet and didn't know it. Wow, you guys were excellent door guards. And goal game. Okay, I'm not gonna try. I got it! I guess the key really is to not try in the slightest. Well, that's all I'm going to be doing in this part. I am speechless there. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part. You know, just look, take a look at my life counter there before I end off. I started with 7, right? I lost 2 because of dumb mistakes on my end. So I ended up gaining 5 lives just in that single level. Wow. Okay, I'm babbling. Hope you enjoyed again.